Hey guys, Becky with Design Bundles here, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have another awesome Silhouette Studio tutorial. Today we are teaching you all about the knife tool.
Okay guys, so here we are in Silhouette Studio, and I'm ready to show you, in the beginning, the very basic features of using your knife tool. Now, I will try to remember to tell you again once I start getting into the more advanced features, but if you start noticing that I have some knife tool features that you do not have, know that some of the knife tool features are unlocked once you upgrade to the Designer Edition or higher edition in Silhouette Studio. So Designer Edition Plus, and Business Edition. All of those will include all of the available features for the knife tool. Now, if you didn't know, the knife tool is actually located over here on your left-hand toolbar. And in my opinion, it looks like a knife, but that's because I know what it is. But if you hover over it, it does say the knife tool. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to draw a basic shape. That way we can get started. Now, another thing that I want to show you is if you notice, I have the gray lines that follow around my mouse. That is the crosshair feature, and those are also unlocked at the Designer Edition or higher. So I just try to let you guys know that whenever I start out a video, that way there's not a lot of confusion involving that. So I'm just going to click on my knife tool, and I do use my crosshairs in advance to kind of help me judge where my knife is going to cut across the shape. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hold down my mouse click key. This is going to be my left mouse click key. And I can drag it across, and you'll see it does not actually cut until I release the mouse key. Now once I do, I can continue to cut anywhere I need to. Now this is surprisingly useful if I need to make modifications such as this. I know this doesn't seem super exciting, but if you needed to be able to create a semicircle or, you know, trim to make a sunset, or there could just be a few different options. Another thing that's important to note is that if you hold down the shift key, you are able to cut in straight lines. So see how it's going to bounce from a 45 degree angle to 90 degrees, okay? And it's just gonna stick with those presets. So that's also very useful. That way you know that when you're cutting, if you need it to be, you can cut a straight line. Now, using the knife tool, that has created all of these pieces to be completely separate from each other. These are now individual pieces. There is another option. Now watch, when I click on my knife tool again, if you come up here to the very top, you have solid and outline. Now, the outline is a little bit different, and what it's going to do is it's actually going to break your design into two pieces, but it's going to break your path. So what that means is that it will separate these two pieces, but there's no closing line. Whereas you can see here, you have a closing line where we cut that apart. This breaks the path to where it's no longer a completed shape. Now you may be asking, why would I want to do that? Quite honestly, for beginners, that causes a lot of confusion because you should be able to cut your shape and not typically have to worry about this going on. That's why it does default to solid, but a lot of beginners will click outline and not realize what it is. And once you click outline, it will default to outline until you change it back. Now, that can be useful, and we'll talk about that after a while, but that is one of the just basic features that you need to be aware of when you start to use your knife tool. I'm going to start with a fresh shape, and this is where some of your more advanced features come in. I'm going to go back to my knife tool, and in addition to solid outline, you also have a drop-down menu that gives you different finishes for your knife tool. So for example, if we have, we'll just say triangular. So I'm still gonna hold down my shift key. And when I drag it across and let go, well now instead of a straight line, I have a zigzag shape. We can also use the square. The wave is really cool. I really like the scallop edge, although that's not what they're calling it. They call it serrated. But basically you can go through and you can experiment with these, and they really have a lot of different uses. There we go, just to give you an idea of some of the finishes that are available. And then, like I said, you can do with these as you wish. But of course, use the benefit of using your knife tool is that it will your machine will follow these new cut lines. So if you knew that you needed to make modifications to a file to give yourself a scalloped edge, well, now you can do that in Silhouette Studio and there's no major modifying needed because you can use it right here on your knife tool. Let's go ahead and take these off, but there is one more neat feature that I want to show you. Like I said, these are just the basics. We are going to cover some more advanced topics. But if you take another look at your knife tool, there's also a feature for auto apply. Now, what that does, and that is the default, but basically, let's select, when I go to cut and it's on auto apply, all I do is drag my line across, release it, and it takes care of it for me. If I uncheck auto apply and I drag across and release it, that cut line stays there until I come back to the toolbar and hit apply. Now that can be useful because if I am trying to cut in a precise area, then I will be able to preview where that cut line is going to happen before the cut completes. Because sometimes when you're creating a more complex cut or you're working with a larger file, it can take time for the computer to process your cut. And that can be frustrating if it takes up all that time processing the cut and then the cut isn't even in the correct area. So it's not something that I use on a regular basis, but it is something that is available to you. And again, it's just really useful to know that that is where that feature lives so that you can turn it on and off at will. All right, so let's talk about some of the reasons why you would want to use your knife tool. Obviously, anytime that you want to separate one part of a design from the other, correct? Now that can work on cut lines, that can work on images, anything that you bring into Silhouette Studio, you can cut with the knife. It's also a way that you can manipulate images. So for example, if there is a group of images together and you need to separate them, that's cool. Let's use your knife tool. Let me show you an example of that. Okay, so this clip art is really, really cute, but it's not something that I can just ungroup and separate. So I really like using the knife tool here because it's just really super easy and I can separate out the part that I want to use and tuck the rest away for later. The first thing I want to show you, now this is a JPEG image, so it does have a white background. Now you can still do this on a transparent background, but let me go ahead and tell you that if you're on a more recent edition of Silhouette Studio now has an auto trace feature. And what it does is it completely removes the background, so there's nothing to cut through. So if you do need to separate an image, sometimes it's easier to use the JPEG image if you can. Otherwise, you will just have to use the eraser tool. We're not going to get into the eraser tool today, but I just wanted to specify if you're on a more advanced version of Silhouette Studio, version 4.4 or higher, then you may want to look into your eraser tool if you're trying to modify a PNG with a transparent background. But for what we're going to use today, and this is a really good example, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on a cut line. Okay, now you see how it gives me a red border around my entire image. And that is important because now whenever I go and I cut into my image, it's going to give me that red cut line there also. Now this is just temporary. The red line does not have to stay there. After we're done cutting, we can simply turn the lines off. Also, in order to give myself the best lineup that I can, what I do is I will use my knife and I'm going to hold down my mouse key and release, but I don't move my mouse again. So I release and I immediately click right back down. That way I'm cutting in the same spot as I've already cut. And that helps me to be able to cut in multiple places without breaking my continuity line. There we go. And now I have two separate penguins and all I need to do is turn the line color back to transparent. Now, these still have the background, so you know that isn't something that you're going to get away from. Not with a JPEG without tracing it, but as you can see, if this is something we were going to print, then that part wouldn't matter, okay? I was able to successfully cut this away from the background so that I can use them separately or even just position them in different places. Now, another really cool thing that you can do is you can manipulate fonts. And this is probably one of the more common reasons that I use the knife tool myself. One example is I can create stencils out of the fonts that I have. So I can type out anything I want. I must have penguins on the brain since that's the clip art that we used. And I can choose any font that I want to. Just for an example, I'm going to choose one of my thicker ones. There we go. Now, one of the problems with these fonts is that if I'm trying to use it to cut a stencil, then this area here on the inside of my letters, the P and the S, I will lose both of those pieces once I pull the stencil free from my cutting mat. So what I want to do is I want to go ahead and weld this together. I can go ahead and group it if I want to. And then what I need to do is to create an area where the outside connects to the inside. So now I can use my knife tool to just cut right in that area to give myself a small piece to remove. And now whenever I go to pull that free, I will be able to leave this part connected. Now, if you've ever worked with stencils, you guys definitely know what I'm talking about. If you have not worked with stencils, then just definitely file this away for the future, because definitely really good information to have. Now, there are stencil fonts available. You do not have to make your own stencil fonts, but if for some reason you just really enjoy specific fonts like I do, I really have a good time and I have a set of favorite fonts that I enjoy, I can now turn those into stencil fonts and use them that way. And it just makes the fonts that I have more versatile, which is something I really enjoy. You can also manipulate fonts that have glyphs. And what I mean is, let me find a really good font for you to show as an example. We use this one, Andalusia. If I scroll down, I can see that I have some pretty letters here. And if I scroll down even farther, I'll be able to see that I have some really awesome glyphs. Now, the only problem is that every now and then I'll come across one of these swirls that I really like, but maybe it's not available on the letter that I would like it to be. And one, what I feel is a really good example is the H, because I really enjoy an H, and this probably sounds weird, I really enjoy an H that has a glyph that comes off to the left-hand side. So let's pull this letter out. Okay, so say this is the font that I want to use. First of all, let's talk about the double L's, okay? I'm going to increase my line or my character spacing to space these out. And there's a reason, because I really like when my L's can form together and that they have the loops, but I don't like that this one has this little offshoot here because it's making it look weird whenever those nest together. So this is a perfect example. I can come in here with my knife tool and I can slice that off and then delete it. And it's literally like it never existed. Now, let's go back to talking about what I wanted to with my H. I am also going to slice that off and I'm going to replace it with a glyph that I like better. What I'm going to do, and I can choose any of these. It doesn't have to be one in particular, but this one I like. I'm going to turn it around and I do want to make it a similar size. And I'm going to slice this off. I can make it whatever size I choose and then select these and weld them together. Now, it's just personal preference that I like my H's that way. I'm not really sure what drives me to that sort of fascination, but it is something that I enjoy. And I've just noticed that in a lot of fonts where the letters do not come exactly like that, it's really easy to go and to manipulate them to be how you want them to be. Now, this is a very beautiful font, and I'm not trying to insinuate that there's anything wrong with it by any means. It's just a personal preference. So once I get them all back where they belong, I can weld them together, and then I will have a font that is not only beautiful, but I don't have to feel like, oh, I wish the H looked different, or oh, I wish the L looked different. So, like I said, just another example of when you could use the knife tool to your advantage. Now, for my next out-of-the-box example, there may come a point in time when you want to work with or manipulate a design, and there isn't an easy way to bring it together. And I know this probably seems a little weird, and this is not a situation that you should commonly find yourself in, but I just thought this one was a good example. If I want to connect these two here, now I could, and I mean this loosely, I could draw a rectangle and weld that together, but I think it would just look flat, okay? Because there's no easy way to really make that look like it should be flat right there. But, and this kind of delves a little bit into point editing also. So if you're not overly familiar with point editing, this may not be something that you want to get into, but this is an example when using the outline feature can really benefit your knife tool. So let's go ahead. I'm going to switch this from fill to transparent, and I'll give us a red line color. I'm going to use my knife tool, and I'm going to use the outline, and I'm just going to cut the edges off, the tips off. And then what I can do is delete these. And what I've done is I've broken that path right there. So now when I double click, do you see how I get these red dots on the end? Because I've broken the path, I can just connect them. And of course, we do have a video on point editing coming up. So if you're not overly familiar with point editing, that's okay, because hopefully that video will answer a lot of your questions. But because I chose to break that path, I just felt like it was easier for me on a more intermediate level of Silhouette Studio, okay? On a more intermediate level, I can break that path and manipulate the design easier than any other way that I'm aware of. Now, like I said, I could have drawn a rectangle and I could have welded it together. And then I could have done some point editing to make it look a little bit more in line with the design rather than just a welded in rectangle. But, you know, I just think that once you get used to breaking that path and manipulating that way, if that's something you need to do, well then using the knife tool is the perfect way to get that done. Let me show you one more example of doing that. This was from the perspective of a design that I needed to fix. Sometimes you'll have situations like that, especially when you're working with tracing images and stuff like that. But let's just say I wanted to make a teardrop. I can draw a circle and I can draw, we'll say a polygon. We're gonna give our polygon 3 sides. And let's rotate it just a little bit. Okay, so it's true that I can actually just weld this design together, but look what we're looking at here where you have the little edges that stick out, okay? Now sometimes that can make a big difference in my design. Obviously I don't want those corners sticking out, but I may really like the placement. What I can do is I can use my knife tool, leave it on outline, and just cut straight into both designs. And then what I'm gonna do is delete the parts that I don't need, which is the top and the bottom. Select this. And now when I say this, I'm talking about select both of the shapes that are left. You do have to make a compound path for it to pick up that you want to combine these. But then once I double click, I can just connect these dots and there's my shape. Okay, so that's just another example of when breaking that path makes it easier to combine the two, because welding would have meant I would have needed to go in and delete or manipulate the corners of that triangle that were sticking out. So guys, let's go ahead and recap some of the things that we learned today, especially when thinking outside the box. But we went over all of the basic features of your knife tool. We talked about how upgrading to Designer Edition helps to unlock some additional features. We talked about the difference between solid and outline. And then we went over 3 really good examples of kind of thinking outside the box with using your knife tool. Because I feel like a lot of people know they need to use the knife tool when they're just cutting into basic shapes. But when you really stop to think about all the things that the knife tool can do for your designing, then it really helps to expand that area in your crafting arsenal. Like I said, you know, being able to have the decorative edges, being able to better manipulate your fonts if you need to, being able to help along with your point editing, and even being able to work better with JPEG and PNG images to be able to separate those and work with those individually. And it even helps you to separate parts of the design that you don't want or don't need to do. So of course, it does take, you know, taking a step back and really looking at it to see what tool is going to work best for you in Silhouette Studio. But definitely don't overlook the knife tool, because it is a lot more versatile than a lot of crafters realize. Let's go ahead and wrap it up.
So guys, how did you feel about your knife tool settings? Now, like I said, the knife tool I really feel like is an underutilized tool in Silhouette Studio. It really has a lot of versatile functions depending on what you need it to do. But guys, there are a lot of basic uses and advanced uses and everything in between, and hopefully you were able to learn something from the video today. Now, if you did learn something or you just enjoyed the video, make sure you give us a quick like, share with a crafty friend, subscribe to the channel. That always helps. It helps us to support the channel and to keep bringing you crafty videos in the future. So guys, I do really appreciate it. I appreciate you stopping by to pay me a visit today, and I'm gonna wrap it up, but we will see you again next time.